So let's start with requirements engineering, which is the field within software engineering that deals with establishing the needs of stakeholders that are to be solved by the software. So why is this phase so important? In general, the cost of correcting an error depends on the number of subsequent decisions that are based on it. Therefore, errors made in understanding requirements have the potential for greatest cost because many other design decisions depend on them and many other follow-up decisions depend on them. In fact, if we look at this diagram, which is again a qualitative diagram, where we have the cost of error correction over the phase in which the error is discovered, we can see that if we discover an error in requirements, it's going to cost us 1. If we find it in design, it's going to cost us 5, and so on and so forth. And the cost grows dramatically as we go from the requirements phase to the maintenance phase. Why? Because, of course, if we discover a problem here, we'll have to undo a lot of the decisions that we have made before to correct the error. Whereas if we find an error here, we can correct it right away, and we don't affect the subsequent phases. So how can we collect the right requirements? Traditional requirements engineering does so through a set of steps. The first step is elicitation, which is the collection of requirements from stakeholders and other sources, and can be done in a variety of ways, and we will discuss some of them. The second is requirements analysis, which involves a study and a deeper understanding of the collected requirements. The third step is the specification of requirements, in which the collected requirements are suitably represented, organized, and saved so that they can be shared. Also, in this case, there are many ways to do this, and we will see some of these ways when we talk about requirements engineering in a dedicated lesson. Once the requirements have been specified, they can be validated to make sure that they're complete, consistent, non-redundant, and so on, so that they satisfy a set of important properties for requirements. Finally, the fifth step is requirements management, which accounts for changes to requirements during the lifetime of the project. And here I talked about steps, kind of giving the impression that we're just going from the first step to the fifth one, and that this is sort of a linear process. In reality, as we will see, this is more of an iterative process, in which we'll go and we cover the different phases in an iterative fashion. We will discuss extensively requirements engineering in our second mini course.